recording your practicing. Universally, educators agree that recording yourself while playing reaps amazing benefits towards your musical improvement. When you're playing or practicing, you're focused on the physical task at hand. It's very difficult to be a truly objective and critical listener while you're playing, even for the most accomplished musician. Recording yourself and listening back gives you a new perspective, and you'll hear problems and challenges and good stuff too that you might not have noticed while you were playing. The question is, what should you record? Since time is scarce for most practice warriors, it may not be feasible to listen back and properly analyze your playing if you're recording everything you're practicing. So, what should you record? It's best to record yourself when you feel you've accomplished a certain goal and want to step back and observe your performance of that goal. For example, you've spent time learning a scale and using it to improvise. You can record yourself jamming on that scale with a backing track to hear how you're dealing with time, phrasing, intonation, tone quality, and other playing elements. Another example, you've spent time with a drum rudiment, slowly speeding it up and slowing it down. You can then record yourself doing this to analyze how cleanly and evenly you're executing this drill. Let's say you've just finished being able to play a piece of music all the way through. You can now record yourself to hear how evenly you're playing, if you're putting in the proper dynamics and articulations, if you're actually playing the right notes and rhythms, and so forth. Listening back to yourself can make you become your own teacher. Hey, speaking of which, you can also play these recordings to your instructor to get excellent feedback as well.